not the least of which is to make sure everybody has a uniform to wear for MPA this weekend. Because as you're aware, young people tend to sprout up, and we need to make sure everybody's got the right stuff to wear. The other thing is this, and make sure that we play through the whole program before we go to MPA, which when you have limited amount of time in rehearsal and you're trying to work so hard, sometimes you don't make it all the way through, so this solves those two problems. We call this the festival concert because it is a concert of the music that we're going to play and what we used to call the festival. It actually used to be called a contest. The joke in Bandrick world, where are you going to play a contest? We still ask that. But this is what we're playing in what's called now the music performance assessment. If you relate it to school, we used to have the FCAT test, a long time ago it was the CTBS test. This is our whatever that is now. Whatever, what is it now?
FAST,
thank you. This is our FAST test. And these bands will go on Friday night and Saturday to Formal Beach High School to play for a panel of state certified adjudicators to be compared to a set of standards and a scoring rubric, and they're given a rating. Now, that rating is then put into a book and sent to the principals, and that's kind of our how we do for the year. Florida Bandmaster Association requires that you play three tunes, two of which have to be off of our list of approved music, one of which is a march, it used to be called the warm-up march, but it is adjudicated as well. Each band is classified based on school enrollment, because we haven't figured out a better way to do it yet. And each band is required to play a certain grade level. Well, I'm here to tell you that none of the bands here at Crestview High School play at those grade levels. We are way above the minimum. So what you're going to hear tonight are three bands that have been working very hard on challenging literature in preparation for what we're going to do this weekend. This is a chance for you to hear what we're going to be playing. If you can make it to Friday and Saturday, we'd love to have you there. But if not, this is your chance to hear what we've been working on this entire semester. So, again, thank you for being here. And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Crestview High School Concert Band and their conductor, Ms. Kim Whaley.
Thank you.
Thank you.
conductor, Mr. Sean Dyke.
Thank you.
The first thing that you're going to hear is called The Passed Out Lifeboat. It is a march written by one of our favorite composers, Malcolm Arnold. Story goes this was the favorite piece he ever wrote for band. And it is about a lifeboat on the Thames, and a light, you'll hear a lighthouse foghorn. You'll recognize it immediately. And later on, at what is usually the trio of a march, you can hear a storm, and the boat's out in the storm. See if you can picture all that with Malcolm Arnold's The Passed Out Lifeboat.
Thank you.
piece has a lot of percussion there. This piece is called Passacaglia, which is a form of music in 3/4 time that has a repeated theme to it. And it's based on Johann Sebastian Bach's last name, B-A-C-H. It's an homage to Bach. Ron Nelson took those four letters, and in the German alphabet nomenclature for music, B-A-C-H is B-flat, A, C, B natural. So he took those four notes and just went crazy with them. This is a very deep, meaningful piece of music, and it requires a lot of the performer. It's an amazing piece, and we lost Dr. Nelson, the composer, this past Christmas Eve. I've been wanting to program this piece for quite some time, and I thought it would be appropriate now. So please enjoy Ron Nelson's Passacaglia homage on Bach. Dr. Cicci, we found out how to say his name. And he wrote this piece in tribute to Aaron Copland, Leonard Bernstein, and George Gershwin. And so you'll hear a lot of their influence in this piece. It's a lot of fun.